Elaborate arrangements have been made to ensure peaceful conduct of elections. In order to curb noise pollution and prevent disturbance to the people at large, usage of loudspeakers is prohibited at night between 10 p.m. to 6 a.m. No loudspeakers permitted at all during the period of 48 hours ending with the hour fixed for conclusion of poll in the polling area. Commission has also directed political parties, candidates, agents to desist from using environmentally hazardous publicity materials and promote usage of eco-friendly substances for preparation of election campaign material. This is a new effort by the Commission, but this is kind of appeal to everybody to use this. CAPF, Central Police Forces, are going to be deployed in large numbers, the numbers can't be discussed, to ensure free and fair elections well in advance for area domination, especially in areas which are very, very sensitive, route marches and patrolling to enhance confidence and reassure the voters. Targeted deployment of central forces in all expenditure sensitive constituencies all over the country. They will also undertake special confidence building measures through route patrol marching, patrolling and route marches in order to bolster especially the confidence of weaker sections of the society, weaker and more vulnerable sections of the society. Preventive measures are being taken by the district magistrates and police authorities to maintain law and order. Commission lays equal emphasis on sufficient deployment of video cameras, CCTVs and webcasting, especially at the critical and vulnerable polling booths. All critical events shall be videographed. Commission appoints sufficient number of general observers, police observers, expenditure observers, awareness observers and micro observers to closely monitor various stages of the election process. Control rooms and complaint monitoring systems are set up with 24 hours toll-free numbers. In fact, on the issue of central observers, this time Commission has taken a conscious decision that wherever required in those states or UTs which are expenditure sensitive and wherever there are major security issues, we would be sending special observers of sufficient seniority and experience and standing and stature to these places. I'll not be able to name the states because that's not something which kind of in advance label state like this, but we have all the information and we'll act accordingly.